Exactly 6 months since the federal election, the Labor government is desperately trying to pass legislation through before the end of the year. Parliament's final fortnight kicking off today with cheaper childcare and an anti-corruption watchdog high on the agenda. But it's workplace relations stirring the biggest controversy.
The Prime Minister started his day in Melbourne.
We know that fairness has to be fought for.
Before returning to Canberra for the final sitting fortnight of the year.
I give the call to the Prime Minister.
Labor's industrial relations law's in limbo as the Senate debates making changes.
These are big reforms that they're trying to do here, and rushing them all through on an omnibus was always going to be a problem.
This is the Parliament's big chance to get wages moving again.
Holding it back is not going to make a difference to wage rises.
Labor can afford to lose Jackie Lambie's vote if it can win over David Pocock.
These aren't all election promises. The industrial relations reforms, for example.
The government prepared to extend parliamentary sittings if it needs to.
We're keen to make sure people have time to debate bills. We're running out of time. We've got a stack of bills to get through.
Including the setting up of a federal integrity commission.
It will be listed probably in the second week.
While Labor wants to pass as much legislation as it can before Christmas, including the IR laws, the opposition used question time today to challenge the proposition that small business supports the changes.
Can the Minister for Small Business name one small business who has told her they support these radical new laws?
Just one. Let's see if she can.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I thank the member for her question. As I said in this place just a week or so ago, we are meeting with small businesses all the time and discuss a range of matters.
No names so far.
And we continue to have discussions.
Take two.
I again ask, can the Minister for Small Business identify a single small business that has told her that it supports these radical new laws?
There are a range of issues that small businesses are raising.
To be fair, there's only 2 million.
Shortages. He would also know that there are many small businesses paying above award wages to maintain their staff.
More questions than answers. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.